It all depends upon your appetite. I'll meet you anytime you want in our Italia. Hello everyone, my name is Agus Maldiva and here I'm going to explain about the wireless communication introduction. Here is my data and this is a class of wireless communication and convergence network taught by Dr. Rajib Setio Arifin for the week 4 of the class. And I'm going to divide the parts into 3 significant parts, such as history, future, and challenges. A little bit of intermezzo in the history part. So in ancient times, actually, people use fire signals and dove or pigeon for letter deliveries, etc. Fire signals can also mean smoke signals. And we came into the 1940s, where we see sophisticated radio system used by soldiers to communicate with each other. And I forgot about the radio invention by Marconi. Actually, Marconi invented the radio in the 1880s. And it is widely applied in the military in the World War II for a communication system. And obviously, nowadays, with the going exponentially growth of the smartphone, with approximately 8 billion users in the present, we got introduced by smartphone or cell phone in the 1980s. It ignited the wireless revolution from the cell phone, voice data and multimedia services, and use in third world countries that is growing rapidly. Now for the future, it is IoT. This is a manifestation of IoT. IoT is widely used for wireless network. Wi-Fi is actually real-time use in this development, as well as Bluetooth and satellite communication system. The technology that is actually created by the state is very costly and less useful since it was applied more towards military purposes. So back in the day, the communication from radio is actually used for towards military purposes, but nowadays the communication services, the wireless services, is much more applied for the private company to achieve higher profit rather than used for military services, which provide lower profit since the user is not everyone. It's only part of the military services. Also, the future wireless network, it contains about, in the next slide. Again, with the future, it contains about the next generation smartphones, smart houses, autonomous cars, smart cities, and other advancements towards IP base, which I will try to explain one by one. So the next gen Wi-Fi cellular, it means of convenience of use in household and main environment that is applied mainly for smartphone. So you can use everything from your smartphone. And then for the smart cars, for example, like Tesla, they invented some kinds of autonomous car that you can control automatically. Smart cities also created by the government to control the infrastructure and their management to be combined together to create a sophisticated service towards their respective citizen. And IoT can also be applied towards new devices, such as nowadays you can see smartwatch is applied with pulse meter and oximeter. While iPhone also consists of Siri, that is actually an application of machine to people system. So Siri is basically a machine that connects people to do things. It's a machine to people system. So let's continue. Smart cities is such as maybe Singapore with their sophisticated infrastructure, for example. And they are friendly with their citizens and obviously offer convenience and easiness towards their people there. So let's continue. This is an example of the future for the application of CCTV with IoT. So you can control the CCTV to detect motion detector in places that very convenient for people to get in, especially in the night. You can make it safer, you can feel safe more because of the application of IoT towards CCTV. Now we came to the third part, it's the challenges, the third part of the introduction. There are two divisions, that is network radio and device challenges. I will try to explain it one by one. So in wireless communication, there is a challenge in the Gbps data rate with no error. The device became more sophisticated, for example, the application of HD version, thus making the data rate higher than before. So to provide higher data rate, we must provide less error to prevent mistakes or prevent some kind of wrongful attitude towards the high data rate. So the performance is still very much efficient. So energy efficiency, the number of devices increasing, thus making the energy is very much wasted, and also increasing. So the number of devices increasing, obviously we use much more energy to provide the device. Scarce spectrum also means that the wireless communication is delivered with a limited electromagnetic wave, so a certain spectrum towards a device, such as a frequency for radio FM, it only express in a certain frequency of, for example, 80 megahertz to 100 megahertz. And the fourth part is the coverage and reliability. It means that people must be connected to internet or wireless communication in every place that is possible. The challenges is to cover large areas with stable internet connection. And availability means the same, that in certain places, connection must be applicable. And heterogeneous network means that the network can be also applied with 4G, 5G, and so on. And also be friendly with the previous versions. Yeah, maybe nowadays people, yes, a small number of people may use like 4G, 3G, or even 2G or before. This is for 4G, 3G, and just below it for the heterogeneous network. So people can use it together to make it more convenient. If you have a 5G device, it must provide this the below generations. And the next one, the seamless internet, means that give the service into another BTS. Voice communication is crucial to provide mobile service to the customer. And to provide communication towards different region, the data is transferred into several BTS. So here you can see it is actually transferred into several BTS. Yeah, I cannot draw a better BTS. I just do it like this. So it will connect to, if you try to contact a person far away, maybe in another city, you must transfer the BTS, the connection to several BTS, and experiencing a handoff method. So this experience, this whole experience for you contacting the other person, must be provided well, maintained well by the provider to promote better seamless connection towards all service in a mobile connection, especially. So we begin to the device. We begin to the device challenges, which contain the performance. For example, we must consider the upgrade towards device such as higher RAM and distinct IoT features. And the size, power, cost, and energy, we must combine it together to make a better performing device. And complexity, the upgrade towards service makes it more complex to design. High frequency can basically the device nowadays have to deliver high data rate based on MIMO, so the development of MIMO is quite challenging. And the antenna, multiple antenna, is actually the part of MIMOs. The multiple antenna here is actually MIMO. It's quite applicable nowadays in, for example, Samsung devices. So in your smartphone, well, probably in Samsung, they have four or more antennas that is installed in a single device. Multi-radio integration means that several features can be used in a smartphone, such as radio, TV, or even streaming services. Coexistence means that it's basically the same as heterogeneous network. So 4G, 5G phones have to be working together and compatible towards this 3G and 4G system. So I forgot to add something here. It should be, there is also high frequency. High frequency and also the complexity. So software defined, so we come back into the software defined radio. Software defined radio is application of the wireless system, wireless communication. It's wideband antennas and ACE ad hoc, and these span bandwidth of desired signal, and it's actually programmed to process a specific number of signal, a specific desired signal, and it is can be one of the solution to the device challenge that I explained before. This is the SDR, as you can see. So this is the applications of SDR. The example, this is the Hack RF1. Let me note it for you. This is the Hack RF1 that I found the picture of the internet. This is basically, this is actually Dr. Jip explanation about the Hack RF1, his device. He explained in Linux software. He uses Linux for the coding. And I assume that some of these language are in Python too. And basically you connect block to block command here to proceed into displaying this graph, which is here you can see a little peak. This peak is the desired megahertz that you want to hear from a certain FM radio, for example. You can hear music, you can hear information from that particular radio in a certain value here. You can select it from the display that is presented in the Hack RF1. It is one of the applications of SDR. Let me close the annotation first. And yeah, this is the example, the application of SDR, software defined radio. So I'm going to further explain about the Hack RF1. So this device is applied the same as a small personal computer, PC, laptop, that is dedicated towards radio programming. The device can also be applied to program any wireless technology, for example, radio as a radio receiver, transmitter, or even a smartphone, just a simple smartphone. The components, there are an antenna, LED indicator, also with data indicator and input-output lock. Also, there is a data communication, and the antenna is part MIMO. MIMO interpretation is here in this Hack RF device. Yeah, let's continue the presentation. Okay, IoT, we came to the IoT, enables all devices to be connected to a single internet network. A device can be applied here, for example, smart house, you can apply CCTV for your security, or even to your washing machine, to your fridge, to your cars, everything is connected to internet. Gaming, and especially your smartphone. Okay, let us continue again. It's difficult to control the annotation here, to be honest. And yeah, what is Internet of Things? It processes the data in the cloud. So basically all the data here, you see in the example illustration, it connected it saved the information into the cloud system. Okay, let us continue again to the Shannon theorem. So you see here, it is the Shannon theorem. The limit expresses the maximum rate of transmitted information over a specific communication channel. Or here you can explain it in maximum information, max info. Sorry, I'll get a hard time writing. Max info in a maximum value towards the bandwidth. So the larger the bandwidth, you can provide a larger information and nearing the channel limit capacity. And here the SNR, the sound to noise ratio, is basically the ratio of sound power and noise power. So also in the same context of reaching the channel limit as high as possible, you can fully upgrade your sound power, extend the power, and suppress the noise power, such as to increase the SNR. But channel capacity is actually unknown in most wireless channel. This is actually in, not is. Okay. Let's continue again. Let me clear off. Okay. So this is the unknown, the factor that affect the channel limit: time varying channels, channel with relay, serial system, ad hoc sensor networks, delayed channels. Yeah, this is the factor that provide limit towards the Shannon capacity. Yeah, Shannon theory can be applied also to design a certain system performance that is nearing the value of the Shannon limit. Okay, let's continue about the 5G. So this is the 5G as an upgrade to 4G. You see that it's extreme in mobile broadband, massive machine communication, critical machine communication. This is the features of 5G with more than 10 gigabytes per second peak data rates, 100 megabytes per second whenever we need it. And yeah, you can see the explanations here, their features, the upgrade and the experience that 5G provided rather than the previous technologies. Okay, let us continue again. Now the situation of the wireless system. Currently, we have 4G LTE Advanced in our smartphone, 6G Wi-Fi, MIMO system in our smartphone, some of our smartphone, satellite applications, and Bluetooth, for example. And future, we have a 5G smartphone, 7G Wi-Fi system. 5G smartphone is currently being developed, and ad hoc and cognitive radio networks. This is one of the interesting stuff. And energy harvesting system means that I presume that a device can increase their own energy independently. So it is basically an energy efficient method to provide the better approach towards the challenge that I explained before in the device challenges. Now we continue. This is a part of intermezzo. Let me edit something. Okay. So NASA. NASA is providing a wired system with 91 gigabit per second internet speed. So when you wire something into NASA's wired system, into NASA router, you can download a game for maybe 10 seconds there. 10 seconds with 91 gigabit per second to download, install a game where in your home you can take up to maybe a day or a night to install a game. But this is a wired system. This is one of the this is the fastest in the world currently. And what is this flag? This is a Norway flag, Norwegian flag, and this is their country view. This is quite beautiful. Norway. I read from internet that they have a 7G and maybe nearing 8G, the generation network service in their country to provide their people the telecommunication service with speed up to 11 gigabit per second. Now let us continue to the wireless LAN development here in the 1990s. We have the 802.11b, mid-90s we have the 802.11a/g, and currently we have 802.11n or AC or AX or Wi-Fi 6G, each with certain features such as here we have 2.4 gigahertz capacity. Here we still, it's upgraded here in the mid-90s to 5 gigahertz. And also actually in the present is 5 gigahertz also. Well, in AC, oh sorry, in AX, it's actually up to 50 gigahertz as I, in IX is 10 gigahertz, not 50 gigahertz is too high. This is 10 gigahertz. Yeah, the speed is up to 1 gigabit per second in the present now for Wi-Fi. It's very, very high. The previous one is 54 megabit per second. And the first generation is 11 megabit per second. Is it visible my annotation? Megabit per second. Yeah. Okay. Let me go back to the presentation. And here in present, it is actually applied also MIMO antennas. MIMO. As their advancement towards an antenna, towards the antenna development. Okay, let me continue. Let me clear my annotation. Okay, so we arrive at the main points of the presentation, main points of the introduction, basically. So wireless network compenses many new application development, technical challenges transcend all design layers, and 5G here must support high performance, energy efficiency, and low latency. Basically, 5G must provide all the challenges that has been given by the device or even the radio. And cloud-based software here is the IoT to control and optimize wireless network. And innovative wireless design for 5G, cellular Wi-Fi, millimeter wave, and IoT connectivity is one of the important points of this knowledge, this technology, and standards and spectral allocation impact to wireless technology evolution. Okay, we arrive at the final part of the presentation. I hope we can learn together more about the wireless communication. So thank you for watching my video, and I hope we can see each other again.